me just guess the last seafood you ate. It was salmon, or shrimp, or tuna. Those three fish consistently top the charts for consumption in the United States. In fact, 80% of the fish that Americans eat come from only 10 species. Eating just these 10 fish, and most likely just those top three, is part of the reason those species are overfished. So I took a journey to the Outer Banks of North Carolina to find, cook, and eat a fish I've never heard of. Because expanding your seafood palate is good for fisheries and good for fishermen. And it's also delicious.
It's good.
My name is Charlie Locke. I've been commercial fishing full-time for about 21 years. It's a tough industry to be in, but I love it. It's what I've done my whole life. The sun rises every day differently for us. You never know what it's gonna bring you. There's nothing guaranteed, and it's up to me to go out and seize the day and try to make the best of it I can. The unknown, in a way, is kind of an excitement that keeps me coming back. There's a lot of bait here, so we'll see. It looks fishy. I kind of consider myself kind of like a guy that grows heirloom tomatoes and takes them to the farmer's market. It's a specialty type product that I take a lot of pride in. I take good care of it, and it's a quality product that I'm bringing to the market.
North Carolina has a long tradition of small-scale independent fishermen. Last year, they landed 54 million pounds of fish, but a lot of that is shipped north, up the Atlantic seaboard, and sold to markets in Asia and elsewhere, where fish is more popular. When Americans do buy fish, they get it from countries like China, where there's less regulation and lower labor costs. So producing and processing fish there is cheaper. Local North Carolina product can't compete with those lower prices, which is why we import 60 to 80% of our seafood. It's hard to nail down a specific percentage because about half the fish we send to China for processing is sent back to the United States for consumption. So that seafood restaurant on the coast where you just had a fish dinner, it probably wasn't local, and if it was, it made a long journey before ending up on your plate. So that's why we're going straight to the source.
Taking it to Raleigh.
So we're really lucky in North Carolina to have quite a diverse array of fish species.
This is Sarah. She's a fisheries specialist with North Carolina Sea Grant.
And the reason for that is we have a warm water current that comes up along the coast and goes offshore at Cape Hatteras. But we also have a cold current that comes down from New England. So above Cape Hatteras, we tend to get a lot of cold water species. So you're looking at your striped bass, your bluefish, and your croaker. But below Cape Hatteras, we have a lot of more tropical warm water species. So those are your snappers and your grouper species.
All that diversity doesn't mean much when someone comes to a North Carolina fish house and only wants to buy salmon. Who doesn't love salmon? Too bad you can't catch it anywhere close to North Carolina.
The problem is people don't know about these species. So they're being sold overseas to Asian markets where they have broader palates, or sold even for bait fish or even dog food. That price point is pretty low when you send to those.
There's a ribbon fish right there. So that's one of those underutilized ones. See the teeth on those things. It's a weird looking fish to a lot of people, you know, the big teeth, and it doesn't look like a normal fish. And it's taken these chefs to kind of experiment with it to actually make a name for it.
Do you want to see the teeth?
Sure.
You got some crazy teeth. I put them up on the display up front, and people always like pointed at it and stuff, so we just cut it up and we tasted it, and it was great.
So if you walk into a fish market and you don't see flounder, but you feel brave and buy, let's say, a croaker instead,
that will help, because then fishermen can go harvest croaker, which may be a more robust fish population and still earn a living.
You need the shrimpers in the sound. You need the guys hooking line and offshore. You need the guys gillnetting along the beach. When everybody's forced into the same fishery, it's not good for anybody. It's not good for the stock that you're fishing on, and it's not good for the fishermen.
Buying fresh seafood can be intimidating, so here's a few basics.
Your seafood shouldn't smell. Hopefully, with good refrigeration and ice, it should not smell. Does it have nice, clear eyes? It should be firm, it shouldn't be mushy, it shouldn't be gray around the edges.
If you're gonna grill it, the trigger fish is gonna be great. The speckled trout's also gonna be great.
If you can build a rapport with your local fishmonger, then you can ask him questions and he will help guide you and he will help you with seasonality of product. And that's the best thing you can do.
You guys, when you're buying fresh fish, it's actually ridiculously simple to cook. Sprinkle it with olive oil, salt, and pepper. Heat your skillet on the high side of medium, and when it's nice and hot, add butter or olive oil. Cook the fish skin side down for 4 to 5 minutes, then flip it over and cook it for a few minutes longer until it flakes when you cut into it.
Mmm, flaky, white, mild. Who needs flounder? Okay, I gotta save some of this for mom and dad.
For more on seafood sustainability, North Carolina seafood, and cooking, check out the links below. And don't forget to like and subscribe.